हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम पूर्वी गुप्ता फ्रॉम क्लास 10th फ्रॉम लाला लाजपत सिंघानिया पब्लिक स्कूल। टुडे आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू द लास्ट थ्री टॉपिक्स ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स बुक। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट इट। टुडे आई विल कवर थ्री टॉपिक्स फ्रॉम डेवलपमेंट चैप्टर। फर्स्ट इनकम एंड अदर क्राइटेरिया, सेकेंड पब्लिक फैसिलिटीज, थर्ड सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट। सो फर्स्ट वी विल कंटिन्यू विथ इनकम एंड अदर क्राइटेरिया। Income and other criteria for achieving development goals of peoples not only want better income, they also want non-material things like freedom, security, respect of others. For development of a nation, average income or per capita income is needed. Haryana state per capita income is 1,62,034. Kerala income is 1,40,190. Bihar income is 31,454. These are the per capita income of the selected states. If the per capita income were to be used the measure of the development, Haryana will be considered the most developed state and the Bihar at least developed state. However, this is not true if we look out from the other criteria. So let's see this table. Infant mortality rate is 33%, literacy rate is 82% and net attendance is the 61%. Kerala infant mortality rate is 10%, literacy rate is 94% and net attendance rate is 63%. And Bihar infant mortality rate is 36% and literacy rate is 62% and net attendance rate is 43%. Actually, this is a comparative data on Kerala, Haryana and Bihar. Now see what is literacy rate. This is the number of people above 7 years of age who are able to read and write understanding. Higher the literacy rate, more developed a state will be. India has the literacy rate of 64%, Kerala has the highest literacy rate and Bihar has the lowest. Infant mortality rate. It is the number of children that die before attaining the 1 year of age as a proportion of 1,000 live births in a year. It indicates the development of health facilities in a country. In India, Kerala has the lowest IMR while Bihar has the highest. Net attendance ratio means it is the total number of children of age groups 14 and 15 years attending schools as a percentage of total number of children in the same age group. In this table, the first column shows that in the Kerala, out of 1,000 children born, 12 died before completing 1 year of age. But in Haryana, the proportion of the children dying within 1 year of birth was 36, which is 2 times more than that of Kerala. This number is 44 in Bihar. Literacy rate in Kerala is 94%, which is higher than Haryana 82% and Bihar 62%. The last column shows that in Kerala, 83 children out of 100 aged 14 and 15 are not attending schools beyond class 8, which is greater than Haryana 61 and Bihar 43. Now, we will move to public facilities. Public facilities which are provided by the government considered one public facilities like schools, hospitals, community halls, transport and electricity, etc. As we know that Punjab has more income than the average person in Kerala, but in Kerala has a low infant mortality rate because of better public systems like a public distribution system which provided health nutritional status to the state. We need public facilities because we are not able to purchase all the things by money. We cannot able to buy a pollution-free environment with the help of money. Sustainability of development. It refers to development of human with at the same time sustaining the ability of natural system. It is helpful to fulfill the needs of the human beings without harming the ability of future generation. For sustainable development, we have use of non-renewable resources like carbon-based or originally designed fuel for the quantity how much we needed. Now, Some renewable resources like groundwater will take long time for replenished, so we should use that resources in finite quantity. Infant mortality ratio is indicates the number of children who die before the age of 1 year. As a proportion of 1,000 live children born in that of particular year, literacy rate measures the proportion of literate population in 7 and above age group. Net attendance ratio, it is the total number of children of age groups 14 and 15 years who attending schools as a percentage of a total number of children in the same age groups. I hope you have understand these last three topics from the development chapter from our 10th NCERT economics book. So thanks for watching.